always loved sharing bits and pieces of my real life with you all, and of course for my future self to see my growth. And the perfect video to show is a day in my life. Today I am in Mumbai and this is how my day went. Enjoy. Welcome to a day in my life in Mumbai. So this is how my day gets started. I wake up after listening to the 8th or 10th alarm of mine. It's 8:30 in the morning right now. I don't have much things planned for today, so let's see how it goes. Me and my roommate Chefin, we don't know how to plan for food properly. So whenever we want to cook something, we'll be missing out on ingredients. So because everything is accessible for us right now, it's easy. We just have to come down and get what we need. So we're going to the supermarket and we are making poha, which is a Maharashtrian dish that I learned from here. And that's one of the most common breakfasts even we have. It's easy to make and I really like it. Plus I think it's light and healthy too. I'm just gonna clean the house now and then I'll also do a quick home tour once I'm done with the cleaning.
Before moving on to our home tour, I'd like to introduce you to my roommate Saifin. So Saifin and me were like online friends for a while, then we started working together and now we live together for I think about a month. Today's actually our last day. We'll be leaving from this house. So Saifin, do you want to tell them how's your experience living with me?
It was good, great learning actually, you know, how you adjust with other person. It was great.
I think me and Saifin make, like I have told this to people also, we make good roommates. Don't you also agree?
Yeah.
Like there is really good mutual understanding between both of us. We do things and if it's required, she'll do it or I'll do it. And I don't think we ever complained or... We never had like a fight or anything, no disturbance, like nothing was there. So we make a pretty good team. So we'll also tell you guys about how we got this house. When I was back in Dubai and she's from Mumbai itself, but she's from another area and we are staying in another area. We were looking for houses and this is I think my second time searching a house for me. So I was checking things up online and then like everyone I was checking in Airbnb. So we logged into Airbnb, we saw so many houses and then this house definitely caught our eye because of just how it was designed. We saw the pictures, we connected with the people that own this house and we tried to negotiate because we are staying for a longer term, we wanted some sort of discount and they gave us the discount. So that's how we got this house. And the hosts were like really nice. They even did a video call, you know, with both of us. Yeah. They did a video call to just show us the place because we wanted to see if it is exactly like the photos. And it turns out it was. So me and Saifin, I don't think we had much expectations while coming. We just came normally. But when we reached here, we were so happy that this is the house. It is small. According to my standard, it's small. But I think in Mumbai standard, it's it's livable, like this is how places
it's
are.
It's luxury.
It's luxury in Mumbai standards. So when we came here, I think we liked it at first sight. Did you also feel the same way?
The first thing that we ordered when we entered the home was home. So you can get the idea.
Yeah. I totally felt like home, and I think every day when we go outside and come back here, we feel like we reached home. It's someone's house, but we definitely felt home here. And I think other day, like because it's Airbnb, we don't have to meet our host. They put the key outside the door and we just take the key. We don't actually see the people who owns this house. But one day Sefin was sitting outside. Maybe you can tell them about her.
I actually went to take something from outside, but I just thought, you know, having the tea outside. So I was sitting and waiting for my tea. I guess in front of me, Shruti and Rishikesh both were sitting, but I was
Those are our hosts.
They are our hosts. Yeah. And I was not able to recognize them because they were looking so young. So I just gave them a look and I just sat there. And then out of nowhere, Rishikesh came to me and he was like, "Are you Sefin?" I was like, "Are you Rishikesh?" So he was like, "Yes, I am." So through like that, it was actually coincidence that we met, and then we invited them to the home. We told them that, you know, the whatever, we were not facing any issue. They were actually very good and very young. Like, they are doing business in such young age. I was actually truly inspired by them.
They are, I think Rishikesh was 22 and Shruti was 21. If we are right, that is how old they were. So even I was quite impressed. I don't know why, but I thought, you know, the host would be people a little older. But when we met them, they were just so young, and they told us they are fed up of like corporate jobs already, and they're trying to find a different way of living, and they want financial freedom and time freedom. So it's really inspiring for even me and Sefin to see such young people take this initiative. And it's a risk, you know, they take the place, they have to set it up. They are great hosts, and we have to mention them in the video because of the way this house has such simple things that make it feel like home. They have everything you need, shampoo, what else is there, like soap, I don't know, even paste was there.
Yeah.
But we didn't use the paste, we bought another one, but even paste was there. Garbage bags. Yeah, that. Everything was there. Towels, bed sheet.
And everything was extra so that if we need, we can use it.
Yeah, and it was high quality products. Like, they had, it's all mostly from IKEA because they both worked in IKEA. So we really owe them. It's worth the money that you put into the house. And I'm going to tag their Airbnb link below if you guys want to check it out, and you can say our name to get a discount, hopefully. But yeah, so that's regarding the house. It's, we'll show you inside the house. It's not much, but again, in a small space, they have done a very, very good job. This is the entrance of our house, and this is the place where they leave the key. So they give us this number which we have to put, and the key comes from it. I think when we go back, we should do the same and keep the key. Maybe next guest comes like that. So yeah, we'll show you from inside. As we enter, they have, I think this is a shoe rack which we never used, and there's a plant. Me and Sefin kill the plant because we don't water it. Sorry, Rishikesh and Shruti. Yeah, so this is our living room. As you can see, it's even this corner, they had like really put so much effort. So they have like put a plant here to fix this light by themselves. They have done a very good job. What's it called, you know?
No.
It's like dartboard. Yeah, dartboard. This is the game. When Sefin was sleeping, I tried doing it one time, but we don't use it much. This is the couch. I think me and Sefin spend a lot of time on this couch.
Yeah.
So if Sefin is here, I'm on the room, and if I'm here, Sefin is in the room. This is our dining area, and I think this is also our workspace. So most of the time we work here, and while we are eating, we put our work stuff aside and eat. We do spend a lot of time on our dining area as well. So the host were generous enough to like give us these board games. They have, me and Sefin only played the Uno cards, not the other ones. But yeah, if you know you're having a party or people over, or if you're coming to chill, I think they use these games. And they have these plants, which is actually real plants. And like the one more plant which we both have kids is that the small plant, these, I don't know, I think they survive without water, so this is staying properly. Now I'll show you guys our kitchen. So they have a lot of windows. I think it's for good ventilation. They have one here and that one also. Show that there. So most of the time there is good airflow and even sunlight coming from these windows. This is our kitchen. I think we have everything we needed, no, Sefin? In the kitchen we had everything. They gave us this electric stove, which was enough for me and her, and we had an oven, basic tea, sugar, some masala, not masala, no, powders were there, glass, plate, even a mixer was there. So everything is already here when we came in, and there's a washing machine for us. It is a very good washing machine. You just have to put the clothes and it gets dried and washed just in one go. Yeah, and there's a little balcony there. That's it. Here is the bathroom and then here is the shower. It's both separated and we have a wash basin here. Yeah, I don't think there's much to show in the bathroom. This is our bedroom. This is the one BHK, so we have one bedroom. The bedroom is very cozy and it's done beautifully. They have this wallpaper here, this red wallpaper. It makes it look vintage, and some plant design. Our bed, we have a dresser, and then we have one cupboard. For two people, this is lavish. Like, you have everything that you need. And yeah, one bed is pretty good enough for us. So I'll show you guys the balcony also. We have a really nice view from the balcony. This is the stand for drying the clothes. So this is the view from the balcony. We have not spent much time here, right? No. I come here for taking photos, that is it. But there's a good view. We live in such a beautiful community, and there is everything accessible below our house itself. There's restaurant and supermarket, pharmacy, hospital, everything is there. So I'll just show you guys around this place. It's called Lodha Palava. It's built as like a township. It's a city where everything is inside the commune, like the compound, so you don't have to go, including a school. It's a nice place. Like, it looks really nice. You'll see when I show you. This is a shop that most of the days we come and have some snacks there. What do we eat usually? Vada pav, right? Vada pav, dokla, yeah, pavaji, and there is kachori, yeah. That, and sometimes we have their sweets too. Today I'm not having, but usually we come here. There is a smart bike option over here. So we have to first log in through the app and pay some amount. It's actually really cheap, and then you can unlock these cycles. It's actually good. So I have already an account, and today I'll be riding in the cycle. That's the medical center, and here is restaurants, and they have like all types of cuisines here. Small supermarket and a shop for, I think, plates and things like that. This is one of the restaurants we come for drinking juice. The park, lawn, or walking track near our house. One time only we came here for. And there's a very nice lake also. With that all being said, this is my last day in Mumbai, and I am going to Dubai, to my home. Going
home. So like I have said, this is the last day of for us in Mumbai, and we are in Ola right now. I am going to Dubai. Thanks to COVID. What was it? Omicron, right?
Yeah.
Thanks to Omicron, our trip has ended. So Sepin, what do you feel now that you're going back home? I think after a month, no?
Yeah, I'm
almost
going
a month.
Yeah, yeah. So I'm actually not neither sad nor happy. So it's like okay for me, but no, I actually
also
like the
emotionless.
No, no, I like the adventure. So yeah, it is actually a little bit sad that I'm going home.
Yeah. Will you miss me?
Who you? No.
Next trip, I'm not taking you.
Definitely.
Yeah. So I'll be going to the airport and I'll drop her or something. She'll go by Ola. And there's like new restrictions because of COVID. Anywhere to reach there early. I got some sweets. It's all in the bag. It's a long ride for us. So I'll end this vlog when I reach my home. But yeah, this is my last day in Mumbai. I'm at the airport right now. I'm actually wearing double mask and I can't believe I'm going home, because I came with the mindset of staying for a year and then COVID. So I thought I'll go home because I felt like if they stop the domestic travel in between, then I'll be stuck somewhere and it's not gonna be fun if I'm stuck in a place. So I thought I'll go and maybe when things are fine, I'll be back. But it's so soon, I never thought like I'd be going. So I'm actually really sad because I feel like my trip is not finished and I've not explored so many places. But I guess this is life. I don't know, maybe there's some reason that I'm going back. You have to be very early to the airport, it seems. Around 6 to 8 hours before departure. So yeah, I'm like bored. I don't know what to do at the airport. Yeah, but I'm here just waiting for my flight and boarding to start. It's 5 a.m. and I just reached Sharjah Airport. I'm waiting for my dad to pick me up. There's my dad, and this is the end of a day in my life in Mumbai, which actually ended up in Sharjah. So thank you everyone for watching.